Welcome to Let's Talk Dementia. I'm Carol Howell, and I'm glad you've chosen to join me. I am your internationally certified dementia practitioner and Amazon best-selling author. You can find our books on Amazon. I've got a bunch of them, but let me just show you a couple today. My bestseller is Let's Talk Dementia. It's hit number one a bunch of times. Mama is Confused, and So Am I. Reminisce and Worship. Check those out. You can find them on Amazon, and you can also find our books and our podcasts and our video series and the blog and a donate button. Honey, you can find all kinds of stuff at our website, www.letstalkdementia.org. Write me with any questions or comments you might have, carol@letstalkdementia.org. I love getting emails from you folks. It just makes my day. And if you need me to call you, I will call you back. Just put that in your note. I have a listener. She's a listener or she watches the videos. I can't remember which. That has had communication with me, and she lives in Alabama, in Dothan, Alabama. She's going to know it when she hears her name. But she has been in communication with me with some issues that she is dealing with. She has Alzheimer's, but she called me this week because she knows we live in Florida, and Hurricane Dorian was coming through, and she wanted to know, was I safe, and did I need a safe place to come to that I could come to her house. That's about the sweetest thing that's happened to me this month. I just appreciated that so much. The hurricane did come, right now it's coming through our part of, or coming through Florida, but missing our part of the world entirely. And I'm thankful for that, but in prayer for those folks who have been devastated. Oh my goodness, have you guys prayed for that lately? Is that on your prayer list? It needs to be, because those folks in the Bahamas, did you see pictures? Oh, listen, my power went off for about an hour last night, and you would thought I was going to die. Hormones are crazy, make you hot. You know that, right? And here we didn't have power for about an hour or so. And I've got my little battery operated fan that I had bought for in case the hurricane came through. You know, it's going to run for like 20 minutes and die. I just can't imagine what they're going through. My prayers are with them. I would like to thank those folks that do support our ministry and through their advertising on this show, and that's Beth Crosby, Editor Beth. You can find her at editorbeth.com. What a wonderful job she does coming alongside us as we produce written word. That's us, me and you. She's there to help you. You reach her at editorbeth.com. She keeps me straight, and boy, do I depend on her for that. And then National Association of Veterans and Families, www.navf.org, 800-352-2919. Tell them Carol sent you as you contact them to get help with obtaining benefits for the veteran, the spouse of the veteran, or both. They're there to help you. So be sure and tell them Carol sent you. Everybody that works with National Association of Veterans and Families, everybody works with Beth. They go, was a good experience, and that's the only folks that I advertise with or I advertise for. So be sure and check them out. Well, today the subject we're covering is I Made Momma Cry. Well, as you know, my mama passed away May 31st of this year. As I record this, it's September 3rd. Tomorrow is the anniversary of the death of my dad. And I record the day before for the current show most of the time. But so September 4th is the anniversary of my dad's death, which is a day that will always be in my brain, I guess. But then the day my mama died, that was something. But I recalled a time that I made mama cry when we went out to eat. Now, you know, you go out to eat, that should be a fun thing. And I know how to handle a menu and options for someone with dementia. You know, I've taught you, and we've talked about how you don't ever hand them the menu with 59,000 items on it. It's very overwhelming. It can be overwhelming for you too, right? It really is. But it really is for someone with dementia. So anytime Mama was going out to eat, I always knew in advance what was on the menu, the two options I was going to give Mama, and she was not even going to hold the menu. I would just hold it for her and look her in the eye and go, Mama, do you want a hot sandwich or a cold sandwich? Do you want coleslaw or baked beans? You know, just choices, two choices for each thing that I needed to know. Well, this particular restaurant we went to was a vegan restaurant because you guys, you know, I'm into this healthy eating stuff. I've lost 100 pounds. I need to lose more. It's going to stay with me for darn ever, but that's beside the point. But we were at a vegan restaurant in Charlotte that was called, what was it called? Bean, B-E-A-N, vegan cuisine, Independence Boulevard in Charlotte. I don't know if it's still there or not, but it was good. But their menu options were different than what you might expect because it was a vegan restaurant. And Mama was looking at the menu and it said like pimento cheese-ish sandwich. What does that mean? Because, you know, vegans don't eat meat or meat byproducts, so they didn't have pimento cheese. And I looked over, and Mama's got tears coming out of her eyes. And I'm sitting there thinking, oh, I could have this, and I could have that. And then for dessert, we're going to order dessert. It's going to be so good. And I'm so excited. And Mama's crying. Broke my heart. Here I am, all excited about how much food I can put in my face, how excited I am over food, and I've made Mama cry. It took a while for me to figure out what it was that was making Mama cry, but she just looked at me and said, I don't know what I want. Just order me something. Just order me something. So I reached over and I put my arms around her and I hugged her and I told her I was sorry. And I said, let me just ask you a couple questions. And then I narrowed it down to those two choices like I had mentioned to you. And we made it through that and she was okay. But sometimes it's things that you're not expecting that are going to, you know, be upsetting for your loved one. And when it happens, you can beat yourself up like I did that day, and it still makes me feel bad. Or you can realize it's going to happen. And you can't anticipate everything, folks. I try to help you learn good caregiving techniques, but you are going to come upon a situation I have not come upon. And that's why you should write me and share those with me, because then we can help other people. And you're going to come upon situations that you're going to go, I should have thought about that. But then your mind was somewhere else and you've got 1,000 things going on, or else you're just really excited about what you're going to eat like me. And I just kind of wasn't thinking about Mama right then. And while that was bad for Mama, you've got to realize that there does have to be times in your life when you're not constantly thinking about your loved one. Believe it or not, it's true. And for me, now that Mama's gone and I realize I don't have to think about her care, it is freaky weird. I'm not kidding you. It is. And I will catch myself every once in a while thinking, I don't need to call Mama. I need to find out if, no, I don't need to do that. It still comes to my brain. So I understand the need you have to make sure to cover all your bases. But sometimes you're just not going to, and you're going to mess up. And it's okay. But write me and tell me about it, because it will help me be able to help somebody else. And you know, that's what we're here for, is to take care of each other. We got to look out for each other. Like my friend in Dothan, Alabama, offered me a place to stay during the storm. That's just sweet, I'm telling you. Got to take care of each other. Well, I thank you for watching my show. I hope you learned something that does make your caregiving journey easier. It's what it's all about. And I am here for you. And you can write me, carol@letstalkdementia.org. Well, a special thanks to National Association of Veterans and Families and Beth Crosby for coming alongside and sponsoring this and our podcast that has listeners in 75 countries, just 75. We got to hit 76 one day, and that's going to happen. But if you are interested in sponsoring our show, we'd be happy to talk with you about it. And you can write me at my email address there, carol@letstalkdementia.org. All right, I'm going to go about my day, do something important, something productive. I do hope. You just never can tell. But I hope you have a great day. I hope your loved one smiles at you and you giggle at them, and that you don't forget to hug them a lot. One day you're going to wish you could. Just telling you it's the truth. Blessings and smiles on your day. Bye-bye.